comes down to this, semi-finals of the FIVB Volleyball Women's Club World Championship, 12th edition here. And the early point, the first point, is for Minas off the block. Carol Gattaz won the World Grand Prix three times, successively 15 medals for Brazil, although she's not been part of a national selection for most part of 5 years now. Carol Gattaz, a younger breed have come in. Gattaz in her fifth year here, 37. On serve, Busra Kulitsli. 28-year-old, career-long servant to Zachibasi. Looking forward to some high-quality stuff here. There's the set, tap back down. Aggressive at the net there. In the opening stages here, Minas. Side-outs being traded in the early exchanges. 29-year-old Makris now. Straightforward reception, and that allows Kim off the set to cut the shot shallow cross court. She knew exactly what the outcome would be there. It beats the block of Bruna and Mara. But another mistake off service. Natalia, Olympic gold medalist back in 2012. Five South American club championships to her name. One of the greats, Natalia Pereira. Lau will bump it. In comes Gabby. Good defense there. From Izashibasi. Going to try and set it once more. Oh, it's a lovely save off the hit there from Mara. Kim lurking wing side, drills down another. Gabby spikes. Yeah, she'll be racking up the points on course to beat last year's tally of 65 for Sess. Able to beat the block. 4-3 Minas. Here 27-year-old Mara Liao to serve. Set nice and high for Boskovic. Really misses those. What success she's had. She's only 21, Tiana Boskovic. The MVP in this championship 2 years ago. Also the best opposite. Gabby dropped back down and out. Next server will be Bruna Marquez for Minas, 5-4. Boskovic again, not getting the pipe attack to land. Digs it out. Push over from Larsen, but back it comes. I'll try and work it to Boskovic again. Not that time. Thrown down just out there by Carol Gattaz. Nice attempt, nice idea off that free ball. Just too much push. Comes it, Adekaya. Seven aces in this championship so far. Not there though. nevertheless sets up the point. Thumped home by Tiana Boskovic, 6-5. The Istanbul native, Gamze, goes again. Gabby receives it and tries to finish it. Boskovic up the net. Larsen there, two. Comes into backcourt. Libero helps it upwards. Kim. Pipe attack comes back. Block down and out. Difficult for either side to get a run on serve. Serve deep there by Gabby. Dahlia. Downward hit. Boskovic. Well, it came spinning through the block. And then hit Bruna Marquez. Not tidy, but no matter. Seven all. Who will lead us into our first technical timeout in this first semi-final. Hands over the top. Yeah, so the answer to that particular question is Jasper Bassi. 8-7 here, first set. It's nip and tuck. It's tight. We always knew it would. Boothroat Filipski serving. 8-7 here, Exacerbasi. Oh, ace! Dump into the net. Enough power and spin to carry it just about over and down. Two is as big a gap as anyone has enjoyed in this match so far. Zalia Pereira, see what she was trying, throwing it into the corner. Picked up by Jordan Larsen. And all of a sudden the gap is three. Gabby on reception. Finish from Luna. Nice and clinical. Reliable swing here. Great length. Makris now. Minas trailing by two. Arrowed serve. Boskovic goes again. That comes back, picked up by Lea, and Libero involved. They're in one now, after a run of 2 points. Minas Tennis Club. Kim, for another. Oh, a ripping serve. Skimming away off the hands of the receiver. The block, the point is scored, and the credit goes to Gamze Alekaya. Timeout. Vakif Bank playing prior in the second of these World Club Championship semi-finals, a real possibility of having two teams from one nation in the final of this competition for the first time since the first ever edition. Kim bangs another down, and all of a sudden the gap is five. That first ever edition of these Club World Champs for the women was 27 years ago. Two Brazilian sides in the final then. Into the net and over. That's a good save on the set there by Macris. Pumped it up and over the head for the opposite to come in and finish. Side out. Natalia on serve, received by Kim. Kim Meyer went for the smash, well blocked. Just can't pull away, Dasha Bassi. That's why Marco. Boskovic, well, she rarely misses those. The sportsmanship evident. Boskovic just checking to see if her opponent was okay. It was a hard smash. Oh, the ace comes in from Kim. Nicely done again. 16-12, so they both. Clawing back into the deficit thanks to Bruna. It's 16-13 now. Bump came in there from Akos. Reach on that from Larsen. And she wasn't perhaps best balanced to hit it, but hit it she did. Now Gibmeier, the 30-year-old, who's been playing abroad for 7 years. Takes a foot off the gas. Side out. High toss on the serve, and it booms over the net, whistles over the net, and a very clever finish again. We've seen Kim do that earlier from wing side. That's the way to get past that far side block. Just flap at it. Almost deliberately slice it, but crucially get the correct weight. Larsen showing a class. 18-14 here for Dasha Bassi. Down that opposite side, Bruna's a weapon for them. Best attacker so far. Been asked to get the service back with Gabby. Quick set, the throw down, couldn't return it. Close to the reception though from Kulitsli's effort. They're running now at a sort of rolling lead of four here with Dasha Bassi. Oh, Larsen on serve. Oh, that wasn't best placed there for Natalia Pereira. So that's given Xasha Bassi to build up the backcourt pipe attack. Larsen, third touch is going to have to come over. So free ball here. Leia with the bump. Gives it Natalia. And yeah, eventually they get there. And it's a good point one in the circumstances after that misfire with the first attack. When Natalia tried to make use of an inaccurate set. Bruna Costa now subbed in for her serving. Oh, what a dig that is. Rally kept going, and the reaction of the players are always the most telling. Because Kim was already wheeling away, celebrating the point. So, the initial award of the point has gone to Minas. Marco Motta straight in with a challenge. Gap of two. Boskovic. Good save. There's Pereira. Flaps it over the top. Clever shot by Natalia Pereira to pull Minas back to within one. Serving for Bruna. Scotland close, but an important overturn there of the service gets Xasha Bassi back to within two, and that is the shot that they've been playing, Kim and Jordan Larsen, to beat that opposite block. Kulichli now serving. Gabby on reception. There's the set for Pereira. Good blocking there by both Boskovic and Gibmeier. But only for so long. Really entertaining match we've got here. It's a set and Kim. Oh, gets the touch. Off Makris for 21-19. Boskovic on serve there, and that's thrown long. Mara with a chance. initial reaction, you wonder if they're going to go for a challenge there. Yeah, they've gone for the TV review. Call is for a block touch. Mara with a backcourt pipe attack. That close. 21-20. It's a big swing. 22-19. Of course, the favoured outcome for Exacerbasi. Now, Natalia. Great serve. This will take some getting back. Off the block again, Bruna Marquez pulls Minas level at 21s here. Whose nerve will be the stronger? Kim goes deep. Well, now it's turn of Stefano Lamarini to the netfold challenge in. Orkai in video review system, absolutely essential. So there was a fault after all. Good save that off the attempt from Mara. Now it comes to Jordan Larson. It's that shot again. And still Minas have not wisened up to it. Wing side, cut shot. Across the two blockers, inside the sideline, inside the 3 metre line. It's a heck of a winning shot that, and they've used it to perfection, Larson and Kim today. Now it's the Korean Kim on service. Very deep, Herrera defending it. There's Gabby, picked up by Simga Ekos. Larson again, tries for the push that time. They're scrambling here a little. Gabby goes deep. Wow. Boskovic and Kim, I think, got in each other's way, or perhaps more to the point, Boskovic got in Kim's way here. Or, well, not intentionally, of course. Just a line of sight thing. 23-22. Pitaz sub back into the front row. Mayani serving. Very deep. An argument for a lead there. Joust comes back. Exacerbasi's side. Larson, same shot. A little bit deeper that time. Punched it against Gabi Guimaraes. Set point. At the very time. Lauren Gibmeier serving for Exacerbasi. Set point. Thrown down on the block. Just a little too strong in the end here. Exacerbasi. They've taken the opener by three. 25-22, and the confidence is still flooding through this second set then. Gabi Guimaraes to serve first for Minas. Exacerbasi won all their matches in this competition. They're off and running first here in the semi-final. overpass there by Kim. And they got a little fortunate off the Carol Gutierrez. Now she's charged straight across. Overpass, a little bit loose on the reception there. Well, I think that was a legal dig by Leia. The circumstances was absolutely fabulous, but no one quite close enough for the pickup. That's the overhead and a push finish there from Carol Gutierrez. Boskovic, big swing on that. An awful lot of time to wait before it landed in a zone as well, but failing to put it away, and they've been punished in kind. Runa, aided by the net. Serving of Macris. Leia with a touch. It's a pump down by Mayani. Quick fire stuff in at the net there. A high overpass there from Bruna Marquez. Oh, nice dead weight bump. Trying to bring Larsen in from the back court. That's her next touch, a defensive one. Then Boskovic! Super spike. Super finish from the super serb. Is just so deadly. MVP at the Worlds, remember, fourth top spiker with 193 points, Tiana Boskovic. Kim serves next for Izacibasi. 4-3 for the Turks. All square again. Dalia claiming the latest point for Minas. Larsen goes long. Landed it. 5-4. Keep my own service. Boskovic. First with the defense. Then with a hit, block working well for Minas though. Larsen finds that patch again. Bottom left corner. Through the seam of the block once again. Silver in this competition in 2016 with Pomi Casalmaggiore for Lauren Gibmeier, who serves next. Good bump back into play that by Gabby. Natalia hits it. Too hot to handle. It's a pattern resembling that of the first set hit. No one able to quite build up ahead of steam, build a lead. Larson again. Gabby on reception and tries to finish. Flicks off the top of the block. Reverse set there. Boskovic gets it down. Got the right outcome too. Diyova Altay, the Kazakhstan champions and the Thai and Asian champion Supreme Chonburi. And then of course, a victory already over Brazilian opposition 24 hours ago against Praia. Always chasing that rally there. Macris couldn't bump it up. 9-5 now. Gabby. Anything we'll do right now. Score off the block. Quick set over the top, two middle blockers doing it well there. Natalia with a backcourt pipe attack drills a cracking shot down. So the gap's down to two, three blockers, but there was a seam. Natalia found it. Bruna, very capable server. Kim on reception. And that was a miscue from Jordan Larson. He's going down the line, but getting it wrong. Boskovic grabs another. Careful not to get too bogged down by this Minas fight back. Brazilian side have been trailing throughout this set. Ooh, that dipped just in time, didn't it? Bruna certainly thought so. Not surprised at all if we see a challenge here. As Bruna got a sort of looping contact on that. I must admit, first reaction was that the ball was in. So they were right to challenge. Natalia brings parity. What a reliable performer she is, the 29-year-old wing spiker. She of the 28 medals with Brazil. Over the head comes the set. And careering away off the block, top of the fingertips. Boskovic could celebrate. Herrera taps down. Kim read it really well. Oh, wow, they managed to dig that up and retrieve. Herrera goes long.
challenge again?
Yeah.
Second time in as many minutes, a shot that seemed very close. That first from Bruna was good. It was called out. They got the challenge successful. And it's the same outcome here. Here, Minas, two challenges allowed per team per set. Both have been successful, but there's a long way to go. And rather than 12-10, it's 11-all. Natalia, wing side again. Can't get it down on the floor that time. Not off the initial attempt. But the follow-up block worked well enough from Natalia Pereira. Just showing that range of skills again. 12 ball, second set. Wow, what a pickup that is off the attempt by Boskovic. That was an extra set that she released there, the serve. But it's come back, as it has, off the tap from Kim. Boskovic running into the shot again. They've got that clip off the wrist of Gabby. So they'll have the point. Kim Yong Kong serving for Exacia Dasivitra. Over the head, and wide that time by Natalia Pereira. If they had one left, I don't think that would have merited a challenge. Natalia got well behind the serve there, and Bruna scores off the block. That's a throw for Larsson, yep. Nicely done again. Quick set there. But Miani, a shot return. That's Leia diving in. Pereira, oh, she was trying that dead weight tip, trying to deceive the blockers, but not enough. Exacia Basi party experience defeating last year's semi, in which Vakif Bank prevailed in that all Istanbul affair. Returning after the technical timeout, Nias get a side out. Larsson, beautifully done. Dead weight, clever. Just having the presence of mind to change his shot mid-jump. 17-14. Over the head comes the set. That was close from Bruna Marquez. Timeout now requested by Stefano Labarini. This challenge is gone, and it's Gamze Alikaya serving. Gabby, that's better. That stopped the rot.
by the time the ball had reached Gabby. There was only one blocker to elude. Bruno Costa is going to be subbed in here for Bruno Marquez. And they've introduced Marlou as well for Macris. So she goes into the front row.
Ooh, spinning just inside. Catch a break there, Minas. Boskovic, beneath the dropping ball with that formidable swing, lifts the lead to three again. Look at that technique to go over the top of the block and still have that trajectory to get it down and inside that baseline. Natalia on reception. That's the set up for Malou. Playing her first points of the match. So tight again. Back in is Gabby. Set. Kim gets it down. Oh, Gabby beneath it. There's a chance here. Natalia, she thought she might have done enough there. They're going to have an opportunity off this free ball. Overhead set. Malou. They worked that to perfection. There was just the window offered up there by that free ball. And they worked their combination to Malou the opposite well. Boskovic. Not clean, but doesn't matter. On to 20 now. Leia, the libero on the reception. This will take some getting back. Even Jordan Larson can stretch and extend and bump that back into play. Crucial moments here in the second set. So Carol Gattaz out of the rotation as the youngster, 21-year-old Georgia Catani, comes in. We've seen her beam some serves down. We've also seen plenty land in the net from Georgia. That's a nice safe one. Boskovic taps. Delightful shot to play. Well, Boskovic makes it 21-19. It's been called an ace. And that's the risky run with using your challenges early-ish in the set. There were two successful challenges, but we'd love to have had one there. Stefano Lavarini. Very, very close to that end line. Serve from Tiana Boskovic. Called in, though, so she goes again. Leia receives it, and Natalia Pereira misses with the spike. Again, the challenge for her is to just elude those two wide blockers. And she was trying to use a tactic that's been used to great effect by Boskovic and Larson. point has been called Exarchibasi's way. Mid-rally, that gives them set point. They have a lead of five as well, so there's a bit of breathing space. Bit. Can they do it? Boskovic goes very long again. Yeah, called out that time. Flag immediately raised. So, doesn't get away with that one. Exarchibasi, they have challenges left, so... But I think this will be hopeful. Indeed, the serve did land out. Minas' point was sustained. Boskovic winding up the shot. I think that was going long. Look at that though, bumping into the overpass. Such was the residual power of the shot. Boskovic, and then the set in for Kim to try and win it. Scrambling and ducking and diving here. Minas off the block. Saved another set point. Tide has turned here. Three set points saved, and now Minas are to within two. Boskovic is going to rattle it home. That was the intention. Minas are not reading the script. This is quite phenomenal for a Minas Tennis Club. Oh, into the net and over. Boskovic tries again. Back comes the block. Absolutely phenomenal from Minas. They've saved five set points here. And will continue on serve. Can they steady themselves? There's the bump set. That block is suddenly functioning to the highest level. Six points in a row now to get themselves to set point. Been amazing from Minas. They're bringing Guzdi Yilmaz to Exarchibasi to try and stop this flood. Tapped over. Oh, they're picking everything up now, and this is the chance to make it one set apiece. Natalia gobbles up that chance, and a quite phenomenal fight back is complete. Seven straight points at the end of the second set. Minas up their game and have levelled up this FIVB Volleyball Women's Club World Championship semi-final. What a turnaround, what a match we have here. That was a go. Now Exarchibasi have just lost their second set of the championship to Minas. Kim Young Ong will get the third set underway. Exarchibasi won all three meetings against Brazilian sides at the World Club Champs down the years, including that match against Breyer. Minas will have belief. Definitely returned here. That's 9 points in a row now for Minas. Kim. That was Ali Kayet. Just can't get a point for local money at the moment. That's 10 in a row now for Minas. Wow. I like a different team. Everything's just working. All the attacks are being successful. All the blocks are coming off. Carol Gattaz serves. Truly extraordinary. It really is. 11 points in a row now for Minas. Boskovic throws that to just south of the 3 metre line, and that block bounces back just inside the line. Thin end of the wedge, that. Good bounce, lucky bounce. It's just stopped the flood that was coming at them. Lands in. Sure, that would have happened in the first set, but suddenly pretty much everything is coming off. Again, another point for Exarchopoulos off the block, which comes back and bounces out. Now comes it. Alikaya on serve. There was connection there from Natalia Pereira, but she was able to make use of the unorthodox set. And Boskovic tries the hit, but they've worked out the threat. Mayani take plaudits for the monster block. Kim push over the top. Hands over the top of the net there from Minas. So they're just beginning to find a groove again here, the Terps. Oh, the throw down into the tape, and you can sense the frustration, and dare I say the worry, amongst the Exarchopoulos ranks. It's a completely different Minas team now. Two-thirds of the way through the second set. Gattaz saves it. Gabby with the overpass. Set there from Alikaya. Boskovic. The pass comes back over and gives them work to do again. Boskovic blocked off again. Gabby tries to tap, and she's off balance. You see there, she was stepping back. This time the lead, and allowed to Boskovic to perform that move above her. Gabby. Boskovic throws it back into play, comes to Kim, wing side, a little loose and easily defendable. Minas going to go four clear. Four.
technical timeout. It's been asked to leave. Joust, who's going to get the throw down? Oh, pump back, up and over by Singer Arcos. Lovely touch there by the libero. Gabby taking that rally by the scruff of the neck, punting down another. And it's Minas who is very much in control of this semi-final now. Remember, Brazilian and Turkish clubs have played 11 times down the years. In his World Club Championships, Turkish clubs have won the lot. Kim, sub now for Maria Ismailoglu. Bosnian form, 25-year-old. Subbed in for a serving play as well. Natalia off the block. Went back into play. Larsen from beyond that 3-meter line. Fist one down. Natalia running into the shot. Larsen again. Natalia off the block. Yeah, the answers are there now. All Minas Tennis Club have worked out a way to get at Ekzaci Basi. Oh, onto the tape and over. They pushed it to the far side. That should have been down. That was a great chance for Gidmeier to put them away. They'd isolated that blocker. Comes now to Larsen on wing side. She's going to have to get back on her feet. Pereira tries the tap. Read by Boskovic. Larsen, two blockers there. That's a super save there by Bruna. Natalia inside that back line for another point. Minas. Dominant now. Been a fabulous turnaround. A rally lasting almost half a minute. Pereira, got it again. Natalia Pereira spiking from that wing to absolute perfection. Pushed out now, the lead of six Minas Tennis Club, South American champions. Inside the home, Belo Horizonte back in February. We're seeing truly the best of them now, of these World Club champs. Zalikaya gives it to Larsen. That time they get the bounce off the block.
one touch challenge here. Wow. And clearly touch. VNL winner earlier this year with the United States. Teammate Jordan Larson, Lauren Gibmeier serving here. Broke down by Mayani. Immediate side out. Natalia taps over. Great dig out there by Boskovic, falling over themselves, trying to defend at the moment here. Minas Leia picks it up superbly. Natalia. Back comes the overpass. They try it again, and that's Makriz throwing down with a second touch. Lead is seven. Astonishing how this match has turned around. Quite astonishing, but you doff your cap in admiration here of Minas. Got a guy up, Boskovic. Nothing coming off, it seems, now for Natasha Basivitra. Urkaz getting involved. Boskovic is missing. Good margin as well. Are they in the process of having to write off this set? Yes, 16-7. I don't think anyone could quite believe it. Sashi Bassi, well, they were playing like two-time world champions. Close once more from Beta Arici that time. Switching around the personnel just in an attempt really to spice things up again, to get going. They just need a reboot here. Sasha Bassi trailing by double digits now. Back for Larson. Pereira there. There's the set. Gabby comes in. The pipe finish. Has to be thrown over there by Yilmaz. Bruna off the block. Yilmaz again for Dilic, tries to set it. Scrappy and scratchy. Zachy Bassi won't mind about that. They have the service back. 17-8, they trail. Very close. Bruna goes down the line. Immediate challenge from Marco Motta. So it's an in-out call. And they were right to challenge. Strike was out. Shot at right in front of the Zachy Bassi technical area.
a loop inside the paint. Lead it in.
Flummoxed. Larsen and Erkaz, the nearest players to receiving it. Quite here, what Marco Motta says. Natalia Pereira. Strong serve that. There goes Larsen. It's just a few percentage points that have come off the attacking play of Exarchopatsy. They've lost their belief. It happen in any sport, can't it? You psychological blow, like the surrendering of all those set points at the end of the second set. Collectively, it's difficult to get the mojo back. Natalia on serve. Minas blocking. Luna throws another, a little too far that time. Deep service. Gabby in the mood to punish. Well, that's a phrase that we could write large for Minas, full stop at the moment. 87.1 kilometres an hour on that spike from Gabi Guimaraes. Acosta subbed in to serve. Somehow gets that in. Third touch has to come over. How on earth did it come over? And it's not been put away either. Gabby taps down. There's a save. Pushed up by Dilic. And Bruna beneath it. And Bruna Marquez will try and finish it with a third touch. Won't be able to. Finally, it's Ismailoglu who finds the floor. Another riveting rally. Serve, Beta Arici. Luna went deep, quick set, gets back to the pipe attack, gets back in position. Overpass here, which gives Exarchopatsy an opportunity. Again, they've moved it into Ismailoglu. Not working again, wing side. Catching a break. Away back to the advantage of 10 that they enjoyed a little earlier in this third set. Minas Tennis Club. Punch down from Lauren Givmeyer, a rare clean spike. They've been able to celebrate in this set. Exarchopatsy, one blocker. Problem to Dimaya to push it past Carol Gutierrez. Gutierrez running around the set. Punchy end product off the block. Yeah. throw for Ismailoglu. Block comes back and bounces just a little long, so that could have dropped anywhere. Really could. Stefano Lamarini has put a challenge in. A little bit of a hopeful one, in my opinion. Close to the end of this set now. Actually, don't speak too soon. I know what happened at the end of the set. Wow! The merest kick up of chalk. Everything is just going the way of Minas at the moment. It really is. And they're at set point here. Great defense again from Minas, and now Natalia taps it over. Minas Tennis Club have turned this FIVB Volleyball Women's Club World Championship semi-final on its head. After saving those five set points at the end of the second set, they went on to win that. Steamroller Natasha Bassi here in the third. And now it is they who need just the one more set to qualify for the women's. Set four. FIVB Volleyball Women's Club World Championship. Minas Tennis Club lead Natasha Bassi by 2-1. Carrying on from where they left off. The block working straight away here. Kim on reception, there's the set. I have to try and throw some down, get some pressure going again, get some confidence building amongst their ranks for Natasha Bassi. Oh, they just can't get a floor touch anywhere. They have to resort to scoring off the block. Brazil, of course, they'll take anything. Service. Ricci is immediately subbed out. Bruna. Booming jump serve. Gets so much power behind it. Kim comes over the top. And a loose ball. Three ball. Tap down. Level, something they haven't been for an awful long while. Natasha Bassi, 3-3 here. Tiana Boskovic next to serve. Gabby, improvisation there, free ball. Natalia Pereira beneath the spike. Carla Gutel sends them down. All three. Jazz beat Valero Lecanet in five sets on match day one. Dispatch host club to Jang in four on match day two. Lost in straight sets, the back is back in the cold decider. Ready to pull away again here. Jazz blocked. Oh, how have they retrieved that? Pereira has to throw the third touch over. Minas always playing catch up there. Kim eventually with the end product for Itachi Basi. With the set, Pereira up and over. Larson. By the double block, only with the last touch there. Larson a little off balance, one-handed it comes over. It's Elliot Pereira, booms another down. 7-4. Well, that situation where they found themselves in adversity at the end of the second set has evidently brought the very best out of Minas Tennis Club. To Larson, who's going to achieve the score off Macris Canero. Lauren Gibmeier serving. Pereira over the top, just look more determined, they look hungrier now. Larson. Gabby gets it back, her opposite number. Natalia Pereira, throw back over. Just getting a little taste of their own medicine at present. Minas. But these volleyball contests ebb and flow, don't they? So often, a basketball game of momentum. Thrown down. Maiani that time. Resumption after our first technical timeout of this fourth set. 8-6 is the score. Minas Tennis Club lead. Nice combination play. Beza Arici on the end of it, opposite side. Plenty of room there, plenty of open court. Ezgi Dilic. Mayani. Comes back from Sindarakos. 8-all. Now the challenge is to go on, maintain serve, and try and rediscover some of their earlier form. But this has been a fascinating semi-final. More to come, remember. Another Turkey-Brazil matchup later. That one's scheduled to start in an hour and 15 minutes' time. Everyone's going to have to get their breath back here inside the arena. Here in Shaoqing. with the bump.
Gabby. That's the shot they were using left, right and centre. Xajibasi in the first set. On the wing side to avoid the two blockers. Cutting the shot across inside the attack line. Crucially inside the sideline. So well placed, the Tsingarakas. They couldn't get there. Try and pick it up. Natalia. Over the top. There's a throw down. Boskovic.
Gabby with a give and go. Tries to arrow that into the bottom corner. Kim with a magnificent save. Makris gives Gabby another chance to win the point. No way she was passing that one up. At the net, but Chris to Gabby, back comes the block. Gabby will go again, too long that time. Clean out. Mayani serving at 12-9. Netting it. It's just those little moments that can suggest it. A change in the breeze, a change in the wind. On serve now. Beza Arici. Rizashibasi. Gabby. Inside, beautiful finish. She managed to thread it down, floor touch in between the defensive bodies. Kim. So subdued since set one, Kim. Gillick there, over the top. Oh, they've just got extra energy in them, picking everything up like that. Lose the point. But that dig that was made earlier in the rally is not something that Minas is seemingly capable of pulling off in the first set and a half of this match. Bruna hits it off the block, saved right at the last there, bumped back by Ekoz. Herrera, Bruna into the attack zone. Gabby goes cross court and misses. That was an opportunity. The player of Gabby's firepower goes down as a bad miss. Serve of Boskovic, it's easily transferred. Carol Gattaz doing what she does best, very slow to form that double block. Xajibasi, the percentages have just shifted. The Turkish side have eased off. And Minas has seemingly grown a couple of inches per player. And at all the individual levels, boosted and topped up. So face the prospect of going two sets to nothing down in this semi-final. There's just a point in it now. Xajibasi trail. Kim on serve. Carol Gattaz opposite side. Doesn't need to blitz down the shot. just needs to punch it at someone's feet. Chance that was. She knows as well. Could have taken us to the second technical timeout. As it is, it's not 16-13, but 15-14 with Exachi Bassi back serving. Punched against the block cleverly there by Larson. There for Natalia Pereira, restores the sense of dominance that they've grown accustomed to Minas Tennis Club. Tiana Boskovic goes long. Well, that is a little vignette that encompasses the match as a whole. Now for Exachi Bassi, Tiana Boskovic, backcourt, high attack, one of the best spikers in world volleyball, and she misses long. 17-15 for Minas. Boskovic, Larson, block comes back. Time out. Leaves three here. Up to four again at this critical stage of set four. 19-15 for Minas. So, Herrera blocking wonderfully again. Chris on service. Okay, beneath it. Jordan Larson goes cross court. Collector's item. Such has been the paucity of attacking riches. The way this match has panned out for Exachi Bassi. That's a throw over. Pereira, good reflexes there. Bruna with the tap. Urquhart, they're going to try and set up Kim that time for the pipe attack. But again, it's just a little reticent and hesitant. And that's why Minas are able to punish. Well, not quite a sense of Minas right, smelling blood here. They're already tearing apart the carcass. Pereira on serve. One back for Exachi Bassi. Macris sets. Came off the top of the hands from Maiani and was well picked up. And that's a couple of points in succession now for Exachi Bassi. So, when the chips are down, they're responding. Need composure from one of the top women, Larson. Throw down. The overpass came over. And all of a sudden, it's the turn of Minas to feel a little twitchy. Beza Arici claims it. Boskovic, goes long, block touch is the immediate challenge, no, say Minas, it's ripe for a challenge this, because we're at a big point in this match. Minas just need to get up to 25, does that point stand? If it does, they're at 21. Not, we're level at 20-20, so this is a big call. Tense as we wait. Oh, goodness me. Touch. Wow. That's why you need the assistance of technology. No naked eye can pick that up. So rather than being 21-19, we're 20 all set for. Natalia Pereira restores the lead for Minas. But they do have their 21. Carol Gattaz comes back in. Bruna Costa comes back in. So that's Mayani being subbed out of her service rotation. The 23-year-old Bruna Costa instead is charged with a responsibility. Bump, set. Not a finish though from Boskovic. Instead it's Gabby. Boskovic and Arici blocked her off there. Kim unable to find the canvas. Gabby can't either. Kim turning into defensive mode there. Then tries the hit. That time for Kim. For 21 all. I tell you, if this goes Izacevasi's way and we go to a decider, that will be an absolute ripper. It's going to be so fascinating. Who goes into it with the greater confidence? Izacevasi have just got back into this set. They have kept consistent with Minas. They must feel 10 foot tall, the way they've got their game together. Subbing one of their stronger servers into the rotation, Malia Ismailoglu. Comes very deep, wasn't left by Gabby. Overhead set, punched back by Kim. Can you believe it? Izacevasi lead. Of nerves from here on in now. It's a lovely little tap set. Nice invitation for Carol Gattaz to level up the match again. Kim. That's a save. No. She couldn't direct it, Natalia. Boskovic. Bayer with the set. Calogatsas goes long. They're going to scramble to try and get it back in play, which is not something that is possible. 23 apiece now. Gabi Guimaraes. It's long. Throw to Kim. Yep. Punches down. Set point. Somehow they've got there. Exactly, Bassi. They haven't put a run together. It's been a reactive action in this set from the Turkish side rather than proactive. None of that matters now because they found a way to get to set point. This to take us into a first to 15 decider in the first semi-final. Makris on the set. Herrera gets the ball over the top. Larsson off the block. We will go to a tiebreaker. Exarchibasi have found a way to win that set ugly. 25-23. And despite the wave of Minas Tennis Club pressure from a newly confident team, having saved that second set in truly spectacular fashion and going on to win the third. Suddenly final of the FIVB Volleyball Women's Club World Championship here in Shaoxi, China. What a semi we've had here. It's the start of the tiebreaker. We had just one five-set match in the entirety of last year's the World Club Champs for the women. This is already the third in this competition. They'll have another semi-final and the finals to play in 24 hours' time. Natalia Pereira goes over the top of the block. It lands in. Remember, first of 15. In the tiebreaker, not 25. Kim. Block works. Sting taken out of it for the set. And in comes Pereira, just trying to dig the ball over the top. Onto the tape it comes. And Minas double their money. Through the block again, the touch was sufficient to take the sting out of the hit from Boskovic. They're going to get another chance though with Larsson, bumped back by Makris. The overpass comes from Gabi, but she sent it deep to give Exarchibasi more work to do. The defense brilliant from Minas. Pereira pumps another shot over. It bounces off Boskovic and down. 3-0 for Minas in the fifth and final set. Boskovic, well, that will do her confidence the world of good, because it might have seemed like she was unable to buy a point for a team. This is Beta Arici, part of the squad, the Turkey that won the silver in the Volleyball Nations League. China 2018. Pancake dig, brilliantly done there by Larsson. Two-handed throw though. Makris try the turn and burn. Back it came. Runa blocked off. Perseverance paying off for Minas. back come. Exarchi Bassi. Boskovic serves long. That is the last thing you need from one of your go-to players at this kind of juncture. Finn. Off the block. They claw back. They tiptoe back. 5-3 now. Kim will go to the service line. Gabby, beautifully down. Incredibly difficult skill to master that, because you've got to get over the top of the hit, avoid the blockers naturally. But look at where this is pitched. Inside the attack zone. Incredibly sharp angle. Maiani serving at 6-3 Minas. Kim Meyer will take the point there off the top of the blocker. Flying away and rendering it unreturnable. Trailing by two here, there has to be a run of service points. Avoiding the side out. Priority number one right now. Gabby. Yep. Failed to do it. It is a side out. I think it caught the paint as well as catching a fingernail on the way through as well. Runa, picked up by Arkaz, that's a throw. Leia, the other Runa. Wow. Runa Marquez, the attack started by Runa Costa. She's missed some of those, she's landed some of those. That time, the line shot worked out. They're over halfway there, Minas. Why we have a change of end today. The South American Champions League, the two-time world champions. 8-4. The deciding set, the final set tiebreaker in this first Volleyball Women's Club World Championship semi-finals. Larson. Plays the shot off the block intelligently. Makris. Karagataz. And although Nezhka Dilic read it, she wasn't able to defend it. 9-5 now, as Gabby Guimaraes serves. Set. Boskovic. That's what she can do. Had to have a reminder. Larson, Pereira receives it, Leia back in, Pereira from behind that 3 metre line, flaps a one-hander over, and there's no controlling that bump from Bruna, so the gap now down to two. Minas have called for a timeout.
Trailing by two here. Exashibasi have service with the Governor Jordan Larson, three-time winner of this championship. Winner of six individual titles with Exashibasi, so she's seeing a lot of highs. At the moment, this is a low, though, for her team. Because Minas are first to double digits in the first to 15 tiebreaker. Two-thirds of the way there. Very heavy serve. It's gone to a challenge. Not even close. Pressure eased a bit. As they have a gift back with the service. And in order to get the best out of it, the Ricci subbed out for Malia Ismailoglu. In comes Natalia, locked back and thrown down. Give Maya though. I reckon without Natalia there, and Natalia ends it too. It's 11-8. The edge closer. Boskovic now. Layup, picks it up. Natalia, that's come back. Bruna, back by Macris Carnero. They work it to the wing side. Punched down there by Kim. What a save. Kim was reeling away in celebration. What a pickup that is from Bruna. Kim will try again. Oh, she gets it that time. Totally convinced that wouldn't have bounced out. Two really evenly matched sides. Kim is a weapon there with that 94.4 km/h spike. So that's Mayani now, immediate side out. ...12-10. Should be a loose ball. Oh, who did that come off last? Bruna Marquez will celebrate a 13th point in this set. What a semi-final this has been. Consternation. Belief, what a match this has been. The way things have turned around. Team 10, Natalia Pereira serves.
Set in for Kim, and she's going to blitz that down. So not yet, not set point yet for Minas, not match point yet. Kim serves. Leia receives it. McCris sets it. Gabby tries to score, but it comes back. 13-12 now. Kim needs another good serve. Gabby, there, it's match point. Two hours and 22 minutes in to a riveting semi-final. Minas are on the verge here. Serve from Bruna. There's the set. Larson over the top. Oh, they picked it up. Gabby off the block and out. And Minas Tenis Club reached the final of the FIVB Volleyball Women's Club World Championship on their debut at the competition. Historically, a Brazilian team has for the first time beaten a Turkish team at this championship. It's taken 12 matches to do so. But Minas have done it, and how. Look what it means to them. They lost the first set. They were staring down 5 set points at the end of the second. They somehow won that set. They actually won 11 points in a row across the end of set 2 and the start of set 3. Won the third. Exacerbasi dug in, they got their heels back into the match to win the fourth, but there was no stopping this Minas recovery. And it is Lavarini's team who will go into the gold medal final.